And okay. Then you go.
Give it to a friend and something else happens.
Then your luck will never end.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
so
yeah.
Then we both get the luck.
OMG. Hi, Pixie Lott.
Hello.
You look the most relaxed person I've ever seen in my life.
I'm very chilled.
Also, you don't have any shoes on because you're on stage without them. So you've had someone piggyback you here.
It's how I always travel.
So glam. So
no,
glam.
I mean, actually, I always perform bare feet.
Okay.
Barefooted. But I had no idea how hot the stage was going to be.
Oh my God, yeah.
Oh my, I was in direct sunlight, yeah. And it's almost like, it's, you know that game where you're like on hot coals and you have to like, it was literally, and I had whole like dance breaks and choreography, which I don't always put in routine performances. And the stage was like burning my feet. And then I also realized that I didn't bring any shoes for afterwards or before.
So none.
I've just been walking around and this floor, there's like glass, there's like everything. And I've got no shoes. So that's why my friend's been piggybacking me around, which
bless.
I quite like.
Oh my God. Right, so from the bottom of the body to the rest of it, this outfit, it's as if like the sun is a person. This is insane.
Oh my God, I love that. That's so nice. This is actually a little outfit that a lady called Wendy Gray made.
Love Wendy Gray already.
She made three outfits and they were all so lovely.
Yeah.
There's one that's completely rainbows, which is perfect for today.
Yeah.
It didn't fit me as good, but right. I think I'm going to wear it after the performance for now, just because it's celebrating Pride, it's rainbow, yeah. And it's pretty perfect for today.
And what is it like then performing at Pride events like Manchester and, you know, you've done loads. What's that feeling like? Because the crowd went mental.
I love it. Honestly, like, I'm not just saying this, definitely the best crowds, yeah. Because everyone just wants to have the best time. Everyone gets involved. There's no inhibitions, there's no judgment. Everyone's just dancing around and having the best time. And I've been lucky enough, I think this is my fourth Manchester Pride.
Yeah.
And it really does get like bigger every year. Yeah. And I'm just so happy that they asked me back again. Obviously we've got Ariana Grande performing today, which is
how cool
incred.
Is that?
So I'm just so excited to be here today. And it just goes so quickly, like the set is half an hour I did today.
Yeah.
And it literally goes like that.
Yeah.
And I was so out of breath at the end. Thank goodness it was like all about tonight, so I can just like jump around. But yeah. I was so out of breath. I had to like hold it together till that last note. And then when I came off stage, I was like this. Backstage,
this
really.
Is why we specially ordered it in for you.
Oh, thanks, guys.
In your favourite colour, apparently, as well.
It is my favourite colour.
I love it. Right, I need to talk to you a little bit about The Voice Kids.
Yeah.
Because this year you didn't snatch that trophy.
I didn't, did I?
Ah,
damn it.
Wasn't the charm. Danny got it.
Like, I know. I was so happy for Danny, though, because I know that he works really hard as a coach, and Sam is... kid who he had in the final was yeah. incredible. And it's so, they're all so good, it's like it's hard to say who's better, they're all yeah. completely different,
yeah.
But I was so happy to be working with Gracie Jane, who was my finalist in the final, because she was just like, she just blew me away. And I'm actually seeing my kids who were in the semi-finals this week, they're coming to my summer school, so we're all gonna hang out.
So you're keeping touch with them. That's really yeah. nice, because at least then, you know, you get that through line with the coaches and
yeah, exactly.
And was it nice as well to up the girl power on the coaching team? Jessie J was with you.
Yeah, definitely. It was just so nice to have another girl there, because Danny and Will are so much fun, but yeah. they go off on more tangents than anyone I know. So I'm always like reining them in a bit. So it's nice to have the girl power, definitely.
Oh my God. All right, so we had a bit of a taste of new music from you in May. Have you been doing the hashtag songwriting life over summer? Are we getting more stuff soon?
Hashtag songwriting life. Yeah, yeah, I've been writing loads and I've got so much new stuff.
Yeah.
So I just got to get it out there, really. That's all. Like the song that I sang today is going to be in a film that comes out later on in the year.
Yeah.
And then my other stuff that I've been writing is a lot more, how can I explain it? It's just very honest, very genuine and very stripped back. It's all about the songwriting and the vocal, and it's very close to my heart. And it's the music that I've always wanted to write, really. So I'm yeah. really, really excited about it. I just think it's a different side of me that people don't necessarily know. So I'm very excited for that.
Oh my God, it's gonna be amazing.
I've just spied a lucky penny on the floor. What?
Do you want it? Shall
we
I get
have
it
to
you?
Pick it up.
Or do you need to pick it up? You're not moving anywhere. You're staying there. Okay, there you go. There's your lucky penny.
No, you have
give
to
give it
go.
To whoever. Wait, hang on. Wait, what's the thing again?
Find a penny, pick it up. All the day you have good luck. So you've got good luck. And then you go.
Give it to a friend and something else happens.
Then your luck will never end.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
so then we both get the luck.
Oh, I feel we're in one now.
Yes.
Pixie Lott, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me. The biggest hits. The biggest throwbacks. It's Baby.